Hello all, welcome to Broadcasting and Streaming Technique session. This is Dr. Sekimuthu. We are discussing about transmitting digital television signals by satellite, DVB-S2. In this, we have completed the introduction part. Let's start the, let's discuss about DVB-S system parameters.
Let us discuss the DVB-S system parameters. The modulation method selected for DVB-S was QPSK, quadrature phase shift keying. For some time, the use of 8 PSK modulation instead of QPSK has also been considered in order to increase the data rate. In principle, satellite transmission requires a modulation method which is relatively resistant to noise and at the same time is capable of handling severe non-linearities. Because due to the long distance of 36,000 km between the satellite and the receiving antenna, the satellite transmission is subject to severe noise interference caused by the free space attenuation of about 205 dB. The active element in the satellite transponder is a traveling wave tube amplifier. You would have studied TWA, which exhibits severe non-linearities in its modulation characteristic. These non-linearities cannot be compensated for since this would be associated with a decrease in energy efficiency. During daylight, the solar cells provide power both to the electronics of the satellite and to the batteries. During the night, the energy for the electronics comes exclusively from the backup batteries. If there are large amount of non-linearity, therefore there must not be any information contained in the amplitude of the modulation signal. Both in QPSK and 8PSK, the information content is in the phase alone. In the satellite transmission of analog TV2, frequency modulation was used instead of amplitude modulation for this reason. A satellite channel of a direct broadcasting satellite usually has a width of 26 to 36 megahertz. Example, 33 megahertz in Astra 1F, 36 megahertz in Eutelsat Hotbird 2. The uplink is in the 14 to 19 gigahertz band and the downlink is 11 to 13 gigahertz. It is then necessary to select a symbol rate which produces a spectrum which is narrower than the transponder's bandwidth. The symbol rate selected is therefore often 27.5 mega symbols per second. As QPSK allows the transmission of 2 bits per symbol, a gross rate, a data rate of 27.5 into 2, 55 megabits per second is obtained. So gross data rate is equal to 2 bits per symbol into 27.5 mega symbols per second, which is equal to 55 megabits per second. However, the MPEG-2 transport stream, MPEG-2TS, now to be sent to the satellite as the QPSK modulated signal first be provided with the error protection before being fed into the actual modulator. In DVB-S, two error protection mechanisms are used, namely a Reed-Solomon block code, which is coupled with the convolutional trellis coding. In the case of Reed-Solomon error protection, also known from the audio CD, the data are assembled into packets of a certain length. And these are provided with a special checksum of a particular length. This checksum allows not only errors to be detected, but also a certain number of errors to be corrected. The number of errors which can be corrected is a direct function of the length of the checksum. In Reed-Solomon, the number of repairable errors always corresponds to exactly one half of the error protection bytes checksum. it is possible then to always consider exactly one transport stream packet as one data block and to protect this block with the Reed-Solomon error protection. An MPEG-2 transport stream packet has a length of 188 bytes. In DBBS, it is expanded by 16 bytes, Reed-Solomon forward error correction, to form a data packet of 204 bytes length. It is called RS-204 or RS-188. Coding. This is called RS coding. RS-188 coding, RS-208 code, 204 coding. At the receiving end, up to 8 errors can be corrected in this 204 byte long packet. The position of this or these errors is not specified. If there are more than 8 errors in a packet, this will still be reliably detected, but it is no longer possible to correct these errors. The transport stream packet is then flagged as error by means of a transport error indicator in the transport stream header. This packet must then be discarded by the MPEG-2 decoder. The Reed-Solomon forward error correction reduces the data rate. How much? You'll see that. Net data rate. Now, gross data rate is 55 megabits per second. We have seen that. Now, if you are using 188 by 204, that many bits will be taken out. That is 50.69 megabits per second. However, simple error protection would not be sufficient for satellite transmission, which is why further error protection in the form of convolutional coding is inserted after the Reed-Solomon forward error correction, forward FEC. Okay. After Reed-Solomon FEC, we have introduced convolutional coding also. This further expands the data stream. This expansion is made controllable by means of a parameter called the code rate. The code rate describes the ratio between the input data rate and the output data rate of this second error correction block. In DBBS, the code rate can be selected within a range of 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 2 by 3, 7 by 8, like that. If the code rate is 1 by 2, the data stream is expanded by a factor of 2, double. The error protection is now maximum and the net data rate has dropped to a minimum. The code rate of 7 by 8 provides only a minimum overhead, but also only a minimum of error protection. The available net data rate is then at a maximum, right? In that case, a good compromise is usually a code rate of 3 by 4. If you go to any DD, Doordarshan, you can see that the code rate is 3 by 4 actually. The code rate can then be used to control the error protection and thus as a reciprocal of this, also the net data rate. So net data rate in DBBS with the code rate of 3 by 4 after convolutional coding is then net data rate is equal to code rate into net data rate after Reed-Solomon. The code rate is 3 by 4 into 50.69 megabits per second, which will give you 38.01 megabits per second. Okay, this is about the system parameters. In next session, we will see about DBBS modulator.